Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. So in today, on this video, I'm going to try to fit a short throw gear shifter setup that is just an eBay one. I've also got a few of the little bits and bobs I'd like to do surrounding this, like the I've got an extension from Torque Solutions, so if the throw is reduced enough, then I'll add that. If I don't think it is, then I might not add it. It's one of those where I'm just going to see what it's like first. But I can show you in detail if you'd like how to remove all the center console items. But if you've got an Evo and you're already going to think about tackling this job, you've probably already seen how to do it. It's pretty simple, really. You lift up the armrest inside there, there's two screws. I've already undone those, and underneath the intercooler spray, just disconnect the wire. And it should be, with this part, pretty simple as just moving it forward and lifting it up, literally like that. And there you go. That's that out. So then, next, down here, you've got two more screws at the back of this part of the center console. And I think it's just this down here. Don't know if there's anything underneath the ashtray. That's a good question. Let's just have a look. Ah, yeah, so there's one more screw underneath the ashtray. So, you know, pretty simple, pretty sort of self-explanatory stuff to do. Disconnected, this should just slide out. Let's make it a smidge easier by moving my seat. Yeah, brilliant. Right, I'll get all this out of the car and then come back to it in a second. So right, now the center console and everything is gone, we're going to look at how we're going to try and sort all this out to remove the actual rod linkage, you know, short shift from the normal shifter. Truthfully, I'm not 100% sure on everything, how to get this out and how it's all going to work, but I've seen a few things. There's also, so in the kit you've got, so that's my Torque Solutions extension. So you have the shifter, the actual short throw setup. That I've got for fitting a gear gate to help tidy up, because I'm hoping that if I fit it on there up to the very top, then the extension will stick above it. So but that is a 12 mm hole. I need to drill it out to 13 to fit over this. So in this bag you've got the counterweight, it goes on the shaft up here, and they also give you some aluminium bushings to replace these ones, 8mm Allen, and I'm guessing that's probably a 12 socket. It is.
Take a moment right here, feeling like it's out gear, driving towards the sun with a rose and a gun. Feel the wind in my hair, going nowhere, I swear. Like an outlaw on the run, dangerous, but it's so fun. Running, running.
for the other ones. So we've got a bit of faffing to do, but anyway, you can see that even if you had it on that setting, the rod is also slightly lower, because there's two settings. You've got that one, big centre there, and the pivot point of the base is ever so slightly lower. So that pivot point would be there. So that's going to dramatically change the throw, I believe. So yeah, if I did put the extension on top at that, it'll bring it up a little bit higher. Yeah, we'll see how it goes. Looking at that, if I want to use that setting up that height, I think that these aluminium bushes that fit underneath to mount it, they will be what will need to be used, because I reckon it's got to bring the housing up slightly to clear the rod from touching on the framework. So let's crack on, and I'll be back in a bit. So, small update. On further inspection, if I want to run it on the like lowest pivot position, I'm going to have to basically make some clearance for the lower pivot rod. So I'm going to cut this piece out there, so that then when the rod is in here, it doesn't hit on that lower down. Because these bushings, solid ones, they bring it up ever so slightly, which is good, but to get that, which will allow better for that actual lower ball position, but obviously need to cut that out so the rod doesn't foul on it. I'm going to go for it, see what happens. So yeah, what started out as what could have been a fairly straightforward, simple job, which it would be if you left it on the lowest position on that one, but obviously the further up the shaft you move it, the less throw you get at the top, which is what I want to try to achieve, so that I can add the 3-inch extension on the top. So yeah, I'll crack on and try and do that, and then I'll come back once I've got everything sort of more in the car and update to how I'm getting on with it then. Right, had a little break there, little gap, because I had to go and pick my daughter up from school. But anyway, so what I've done is, so far, I have modified the like sort of plastic housing for the actual shifter itself slightly. It's not great. I could have done it better. Started using the Dremel, and then yeah, I needed to get more and more and more clearance, so I got a bit more impatient with it all and just started using a bit of a chisel on it and different things in the end. So yeah, don't look amazing, but that's how much I've chopped out of it. So I suppose I best bolt this down. I am going to use these alloy bushes, and I believe they need extra washers on top for it to fix down so that it doesn't pull it all through, because that raises it up more, so that when that's pushed into the lower position on the new rod, it gives you a bit more clearance as well. Actually, a little bit of grease. That didn't work. Okay, right, I'll find that in a second. I wasn't expecting that to happen, was I? Right, that one's on. Let's find that. Right, that's both of them clipped on. So, trying to remember the process. Plenty of left to right movement there. Wicked. So this went that way. Sorted. Okay, I don't think I over tightened that too much. I think that's tight. I think that's good. I think everything's where it should be. I'm happy with that. Just wonder what it's going to be like for shifting. So then the next thing I'll do once I get, I might put this on now. So this is like a counterweight. Not fully sure where it wants to go. Whether I can put it like that way up. Because it's obviously it's got like a little hole to go there, but that's a lot of the thing up the wrong way around. I suppose I could put it like that. How far down can it go? Yeah, give it a go. Nice. So, Torque Solutions extension that will go on like so. In fact, there's just enough room to put that under there. So I'm hoping the gear gator will come up to there and just finish. So that'll finish underneath the Torque Solutions extension. So that extension, look, should be a nice. So, I mean, the throw's no real different to how it was standard with the gear knob up there. But you've got that extra height. And I think that, for me, with the reduced throw, is a massive plus. I mean, obviously, well, I'll just get the gear knob. So, obviously, if we was just fit this straight on, I think the throw's reduced dramatically. That's insane. Okay, I'm pretty happy with that. I think it's time to start reassembling all the center console. Now everything's bolted down, bolted back together. Do I put the extension on is the question. Do I think it needs it? I'm not sure. But that I can always do afterwards and take off if I don't enjoy it or like it. It's not something that all the center console needs to be off for. So yeah, let's bang it all back together. Hold me close till I get up. Time is barely on our side. Two Phillips screws. In the UK these days we use Posi for some reason. Japanese still use Phillips stuff. What's left? And on and on. We'll
it's cut out that way, so it's got to go that way. There's a little cut out in that section, slips into there, so it only goes one way. And then there's just these two screws back in the centre console in here in the arm rest. So the Torx Solutions extension is on. I don't know if my Tome gear knob is going to foul on the hexagon part or not, but I'm going to tighten it down a bit and see what happens. So obviously I've gained height by about, what, 2 inches now because of that being lowered, this being higher up. So it's a nice height. The travel would be reduced if it was lower down on the original like height position. I don't think the travel's that much extended, but if I get the steering wheel quickly and just see how it feels all sort of in how I want it. So pop the steering wheel back on. Like I say, I don't think the throw is massively increased by having that extension with the short shift to how it originally was. Do I prefer that position of the gear lever for changes? Yes, it's much more comfortable because my arm is not like down here. I guess best thing to do is probably take that back off, try it without, try it with, and see what happens, see how I feel. So I think that's what I'll do. So everything's back in the car now. I've put all the center console all back in and everything. I've took that back off, which I did put on, and the Torx Solutions extension for now. I'll see whether I like them in the future, but at the moment this is how it sits with the original gear gator and the Tome knob onto the quick shift new setup. So this is it through first, through to fifth. Ready? He says. That's it. First, second, third, fourth, fifth. Jeez, it feels so weird actually. First, second, third, fourth, fifth. Where's fifth? Right, first, second. First, second, third, fourth, fifth. Oh my god, that feels weird. I don't even feel like I'm getting the gears. Yeah, so it's considerably shorter and quicker with the throw. What I'll do now is just finish it all up and take it out for a spin, take it for a test drive. Might take the camera with me, show you guys what it's like, but other than that, I think that's it for now. So if you like what you've seen on the video, yeah, by any means, you know, you can always sub or give us a like, and I'll catch you in the next one.